Oh, ladies and gentlemen, it's a new day and it's a new bike ride this morning.
Yeah, good morning, welcome back to the vlog. It was an absolute mission getting out on the bike today. I'm not gonna lie, the old pins, yeah, they ain't happy today.
I woke up and I was like, guys, we're going for a bike ride. And they were like, no, hell no.
Feeling pretty cooked, that's the word I'm gonna use today, not cooked. Feeling pretty cooked after the last couple of days. We've got a bit of an easier ride planned today. There's a couple hours, and it even says in my notes on my Training Peaks account, cafe ride. So, cafe ride is what I will do. Heading out right now to meet Brian, do a couple hours with him, and then finishing off with said cafe. Kind of the usual play at the minute, wet start. However, the sun is coming out over there in the background. We got some blue skies coming through, so hopefully. Oh, look at that dry piece of road. Should be a decent day. We're on a little bit of a time schedule today. According to my trusty weather app, which isn't so trusty, there's a storm brewing. There is a storm brewing, and it's going to be coming in about 1 p.m. It's about 12:30 right now. Been riding for like an hour and a half, and yeah, clouds are coming in, and they're looking dark. My house is that way, so I intend on climbing to the top of this road and then beating the inevitable storm back home, because I don't want to get stuck in the storm. Especially not when it's blue skies that way. I love this. I'm currently climbing up a segment called Hunter's Hill Pub to Pub. Pretty common climb where I live. My PR up here is 3 minutes 58 seconds. And today my estimated arrival time is pretty much 7 minutes. I'm just cruising for a bruising. Can confirm, no records are getting beaten today.
There's the two. Done and dusted, absolutely bang on 2 hours. What you saying? Even made it back before the rain started, so happy days.
You know you've timed an easier day, like, well. When I'm riding along, I think today I averaged 178 watts. And I was riding along like, 178 watts, mate, this feels hard. So yeah, thankful that today was a rest. And it's slightly alarming because next week we head to France and then we're doing a race called GP Bavay on Sunday. Then on Monday we're racing a Belgian Kermes, and then on Tuesday we're racing GP Marbriers, which is a UCI 1.2 event. So that's 3 days back-to-back racing, and right now I'm thinking.
But in slightly more negative news, I just returned home and Lexi came to greet me like she always does, and she's limping. Look at that. What's up with your leg?
Like, when I woke up this morning she was absolutely fine, but it seems like she doesn't want to put any pressure on this left leg. What have you done to it?
Like, I'm trying to have a look inside in a paw, but it doesn't seem like she's got anything in it. How have you done that?
I bet she's been jumping on the trampoline.
I bet that's what she's been doing.
You've been jumping off the trampoline? Look at her, she can barely walk on it. Come on, come inside and lie down.
Just literally devoured about half a pack of Walker Sensations. Hashtag
And anyway, guys and girls, it's been off and on raining all day. Currently it's sunny again. It just seems like the UK has some serious bipolar weather at the minute, but I'm not going to complain because right now it's sunny. Anyway,
as I mentioned in my video yesterday, this weekend is my parents' like 25th wedding anniversary. So because it's that, the whole family is like going to go up to the Lake District this weekend, so obviously I'm going to be taking my bike.
But more so, I need to remember, take a kit bag, because on Sunday I'm racing down in Newcastle under Lyme, which is like Staffordshire area, I think, which is actually like south of where I am. The Lake District is north of where I am, so it's going to be like an extra long drive, but I get to spend the weekend in the Lake District as a consequence. So anyway, even though I'm going to be going to the Lake District and doing a bit of riding there and spending time with the family, I also need to kind of pack my bag today as if I'm going racing, which is kind of a weird mentality, because I've got to pack my kit bag, got my skin suit, my race, my pins, my race license, and also stuff like washing equipment, including some gunk degreaser, which is, by the way, the best degreaser in the whole entire world. If you don't use this, I highly recommend you try it. And yeah, so then after I do my pre-race ride tomorrow, I can give the bike a wash and we're ready to race. Woo! So anyway, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm packing my bag, or I'm gathering up my equipment to pack my bag.
All right, one thing we need to do before we set off is charge the old Di2. We are on solid red, which means we've got about 25% battery. So theoretically, it should last for the weekend, but the Lake District is hilly, and that means I have to change gear lots of times. So I'm probably gonna run out.
Di2 is so foolproof to use. Like, it literally takes 2 or 3 hours to charge the battery, and then it just lasts for like 2 months. Anyone that runs out of battery with Di2, like, how do you do it? How?
Bosh, bag's packed.
Welcome everybody to a new dawn, to a new day, to the lovely, picturesque Lake District in Windermere. According to Mr. Weatherman this morning, we've got like the worst ever recorded floods and storms and rainfall in August ever. So yeah, I mean, this morning, the whole morning, all last night and all this morning, it just absolutely hammered it down. The lake has like risen like 3 or 4 inches in height just in one night worth of rain, which is absolutely like unheard of. It's insane. And basically, like, the forecast today is thunderstorms. I just got a notification from Met Office to say like there's amber warnings of thunderstorms like for the entirety of the day. So I waited until like 10 o'clock and the rain actually stopped. It's actually stopped right now, and it doesn't look too bad, but I know, like, inevitably the rain's coming back. So it was a case of today limiting as much time as I spent in the rain as possible. So I waited for a little bit of an opening. We've been riding for 5 minutes, 8 minutes. It's still dry, so, you know, we're winning so far.
But I mean, like, in terms of the temperature, it's still at 18 to 20 degrees. It's not cold at all. So I thought, like, I mean, I'll just crack on. Like, all I'm doing today is a 1 hour 30 pre-race ride. So if I get a bit wet, if the clouds rain on me, who cares? Who cares? Whee! Oh, that's the bottom bracket gun. All of the puddles today. All of the puddles.
Look at that! There's just like floods and puddles everywhere. But anyway, today I intended doing the standard pre-race ride I do in the Lake District, which is a lap of the lake. It's 1 hour 35. It's pretty much an ideal route. It's pretty rolling, open. Then on the way back from Ambleside, there's an ideal spot to do a 10 minute tempo effort. So let's crack on and see how long I can avoid the rainfall. Oh man, look at this. All right, this is the deepest one yet. I think I'm gonna walk on the curb there. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Look how deep it is, man. Look how deep it is. This is insane. Look at all the cars. Man, the cars, I'm glad I didn't come like flying over that hill and straight into that. That would have been straight over the handlebars. Go on, your turn, buddy. Orange car doesn't want to do it. He's doubting it. He's doubting his ability to go through. Oh my God. Oh my God. See how low that was? That is absolutely jokes. I feel like there's going to be a few of those on today's ride. Hey, it's an adventure. We all love an adventure. I'd slow down, buddy. I'd slow down. There you go. Yep. Didn't last long. 18 minutes. All right, so I've done about an hour, just over an hour. Starting to head back in towards Ambleside, which is where I'm going to do like the 10 minute press on a little bit, just a bit of an opener ahead of racing tomorrow. It's kind of just been off and on, like this rain the whole ride. Like, it isn't actually too bad. I quite enjoy it. It's quite refreshing, but I've just made it to this river here, right?
Look at that. So for context, the river normally is like, see where that wash is there? It kind of follows that line around there. So it's like that wide, I don't know, 8-10 meters wide. But look at it today, guys. It is literally like overspilled. I mean, I don't think that's the technical term, but it's overspilled into the side here, into the banking, and it is just like a mini lake. What?
Normally this time of the year, it's pretty congested in there. People come down for a picnic, go for a swim in the river. Don't think there's any swimming gonna be going on today. And that's the ride done. 1 hour 30. Actually, 1 hour 24. We did it a little bit quicker than what I would normally do a lap of the lake. I think it's just because it was wet, so naturally I was just pressing on a little bit harder.
But that is a pre-race ride done ahead of tomorrow. Bosh. And just like that, the bike is looking absolutely fresh and absolutely clean as a new you. Look, he's waiting for me. Hello. Have you been waiting there for the last 90 minutes? Hey? Come here. Come here. Oh, look at her leg, man. Is your leg still sore? Hey? What have you done to that leg?
And as by tradition, regardless of the weather, whether it's sunny, whether it's raining, whether it's snowing, one way to end a bike ride in the Lake District is in the water. Woo!
Are you coming in, Lex? You coming in?
That actually felt surprisingly warm. I think it's because like my body's cold. So getting into a cold lake, the temperature differential isn't that big.
I feel pretty cold now then. Guys, so since I got home from my ride, it's now, the time's now 5 minutes past 6, and I haven't picked up the camera kind of all day. Yeah, I'm vlogging. I know, I'm a weirdo. Get over it. I haven't picked up my camera all day because the weather's just been like this, and I came out into town, into Bowness. I just had to go to the shop and get some food for dinner, but I came into Bowness thinking like the weather had stopped, I can walk through a little bit, do some filming, do some vlogging, take you guys down the road, because over there, don't know if you can see it, there, that one, it's called Dr. Brew's Coffee House, and apparently it's a new cafe that's arrived to Bowness, and apparently like a couple of people have messaged me saying that I should go there because it's good, and I mean, it's too late now to go for a coffee anyway, it's 6 o'clock and the cafe's shut, but I wanted to go and check it out. And generally just have a bit of a walk through the town and have a look what's going on. And then it bloody started raining again. All day it's been doing this. And I finally thought the rain had finished, but no. It's come back again and it's currently raining again. So I'm sat in the car giving you guys this explanation. But on that note, guys, I'm gonna cut the vlog short, end it here, because there's just not a lot else that's gonna happen today with the weather being like this. Tomorrow looks to be a better day. In the afternoon or in the evening, I'm gonna be going down to Staffordshire, to Newcastle under Lyme, to take part in a town centre crit. So fingers crossed. I mean, according to my trusty weather app on my phone, it says it's going to be a little bit nicer than it is today, but fingers crossed, the sun comes out tomorrow, we can do some more fun activities and just enjoy the Lake District a little bit more than this. Guys, I'd really appreciate if you just click the like, click the like button, leave us a like in the video, drop a comment down below. Also, I don't know about you guys, but like when I'm at home and when I'm just filming my rides and stuff and going out training, like I don't really massively enjoy filming those videos, and I don't know whether you guys also don't massively enjoy watching those videos. Like I'm just at home, I'm doing my normal routine, like it's not really that exciting, like I don't really lead that exciting of a lifestyle, but like when I go away, when I go traveling, when I go to France, when I go to Italy or to Belgium, like racing, it's just so much more fun and entertaining, and like I've got more people that I can vlog with and stuff. There's quite a few trips coming up in the works over the next few months, so stay tuned, stay locked into the videos, leave a like, and I'll see you guys tomorrow at the same usual time of 5 p.m. Peace! And I'll leave you alone.